on the Caprivi Strip, an area of land at the border.
A Zambian helicopter took Neil Kinnock close to South African military bases along the Zambezi. On the other side of the river is Namibia, territory South Africa occupies illegally in defiance of the United Nations. From a Zambian border post, the Kinnocks could just make out a South African gun emplacement. From their bases here, the South Africans have mounted a series of raids into Zambia in pursuit, they say, of the ANC. Mr. Kinnock describes the raids as part of state-sponsored terrorism. Mr. Kinnock says his commitment to sanctions is stronger than ever now, and of Mrs. Thatcher's fierce opposition.
I think to her, this part of the world is a matter of small moment concerning countries a very long distance away. And she therefore has a very introverted attitude towards the interdependence of the different countries of the world.
Later, the Kinnocks were shown devastated houses inside Zambia. At this one, a South African bomb killed two civilians, one the Prime Minister's niece. Sanctions were championed again at a lunch given by the Zambian government. The Zambians undermined their own commitment a little by serving South African wine. Mr. Kinnock says he drank it to avoid giving offence. The episode underlined Zambia's failure to find alternative sources of supply. But it also showed the very real difficulties such a poor country faces. South Africa deliberately monopolises much cheap local produce. No controversy at the last stop of the day, Victoria Falls. Here, politics was overwhelmed by the irresistible force of nature.